How do you rate album?
It's all right.
Only all right?
Well, there's nothing else to compete with this. I knew exactly what I wanted, and I got exactly what I expect. Ask myself.
Can we talk
That's
about...
the fun of being me.
You get exactly the audience response that you expected?
Not the last time I played here, no.
They were gobbing on you,
yeah, they were, the filthy bastards.
Why do you think they like to
do that?
They
better not do that tonight, because I'll turn a fucking hose on them.
Why do you think they like to do that so badly? They save up, you know, they go...
No, look, it's like this, they've read this few pieces of nasty rubbish that the press seems to love to promote as being what punks do, and that is not what punks do.
Mm. What do
you only you spit on your enemy. Not your best friends.
Are there any punks left in the world?
I hope not. It's
all...
a term I've never liked.
Punk rock was finished when the Damned played the first gig.
They're sort of in a way like hippies now.
Worse, particularly like after watching Stonehenge. Have you heard about that?
No.
Oh, the Druid Festival.
Yeah, I did, actually.
Well, they showed them on English telly, and all it was mohawks in leather jackets.
Right.
They are the new hippie movement.
That's it.
Disgusting breed.
Well, it seems to me that they consolidate around three basic issues.
They're more conservative than the very thing that they're supposed to be against, because they all wear an identical outfit, a uniform.
Mm. Mm-hmm.
They have lost their sense of identity.
What do you
think? They have no sense of self-importance. They're clones.
Mm.
They're worse than Wham fans.
But of all the young groups in society, it seems to me they're the only ones with a social conscience. They're the only ones who are singing about political issues and who feel strongly about vivisection and who go on marches against nuclear armament build-ups and so on.
No, it tends to be silly old tosspots. You know, all these marches don't achieve very much at all.
Mm. Do you have a social conscience at all?
Yes, somewhere in the back of my brain.
Does it figure in any of your songs?
I think so. Album completely reeks of it, doesn't it?
Reeks of social conscience?
Yes, we're all going to die. So we might as well lead a happy existence up until that moment. Nuclear holocaust is imminent. I could be wrong, I could be right. I could be black, I could be white. I could be right, I could be wrong. I could be white, I could be black. Your time has come, your second skin. So high, the gain so low. Walk through the valley. The written word is a lie.
May the road rise with you. May the road rise with you. May the road rise with you.
Now, I hate to admit it to you face to face, but actually, I think album is a terrific record, mainly because it's a kind of a bastard child of all kinds of different musical parents, the way it just throws labels out the window. I think it's really exhilarating in that way.
The thing about music is you can't allow yourself to be bracketed into these small little narrow cliques, like, I am just a heavy metaler, I am just a punk, I am just this, that. Rubbish. Why settle for something so cheesy? Have it all.
Can we talk about some of the songs on the record? Like Rise. What is Rise about? This is a good song.
Good luck. May the road rise with you, because life's a piece of shit when you think of it.
Round?
Nuclear holocaust, imminent, mushrooms on the horizon.
Ronald Rambo.
Ronald Rambo, ray gun, fishing.
Just the nastiness of human beings. You'll crawl back into your own dustbin.
How about FFF?
Farewell to fair-weather friends. There's a hell of a lot of them in the music business. Clingers, dead wood, dead weights. So well, I took great pleasure just flicking them out of my life.
Right. Was this a generic flick or was it intended for anybody in particular?
It's a generic flick.
Hmm.
A new concept.
Just add water. So,
well, obviously, you know, that sort of relates to the likes of Mr. McLaren.
We spoke to Malcolm McLaren about 9 months ago.
Yeah, and I bet you didn't understand a word.
Well, he talked, actually, for about an hour.
And none of it made any sense.
Can I tell you what he said about you?
No, I don't want to know. It's irrelevant.
Mm.
Next.
I'm going to tell you anyway, frankly.
No, and I'm not going to listen. I'll just get up and walk.
Will you?
Yes.
Yeah, you don't really.
The voice of the ranting and the raving, obsequious, jealous, does not appeal to me.
Next on the new music, what exactly Malcolm McLaren did say about his royal rottenness.
Unrequited love, really. I realized that all they needed was a poet. And so I stood in my shop and I waited for this poet to enter. And he entered one day, gruff and rough and mean and shy, for a pair of shoes. And I asked him if he could sing. He kind of looked at me as if I was trying to take him for something or other. And he said, "You're only out of tune, though." I said, "Well, can you play anything?" "Yeah, the violin, also out of tune." And I thought, well, he's a right stroppy bugger.
Recently, Johnny Lydon said that he was sorry that Sid Vicious had died, but he wished that you were dead. Why did he say that, and what did you think?
Well, I suppose unrequited love, really. He felt that he was a poet, and poets should get the necessary accolades, because the band's governing rule and professed media image was of a band that couldn't play.
So bitter was their divorce that Johnny Rotten sued Malcolm McLaren on several counts: that McLaren did not own the name the Sex Pistols, that McLaren owed Rotten a huge share of the Pistols' profits, that McLaren was making the movie The Great Rock and Roll Swindle without Rotten's approval, and that he was illegally using Sex Pistols' money to produce it. This year, the case was resolved. According to the British press, John Lydon came running out of the courtroom waving a check for close to £1 million above his head and shouting, "It's mine, all mine."
Everywhere I read in interviews with you, you talk about nowadays your main ambition in life is to be filthy, stinking rich, as if you were some kind of musical mercenary. But I think I've sussed you out a little better than that. I think you really like music a lot more than you'll ever let on.
Well, yeah. Well, let's face it, I couldn't possibly be doing this for the money.
Aren't you making money?
I'm not the commercial success that record companies love and adore.
Right. But you said earlier on that you got everything from this record that you anticipated.
I question far too much.
Mm. You question what?
The entire business, the entire establishment, all of it. It all stinks and it must all be replaced.
Now, do you really think that young music lovers really care about the business?
They should. If they want to grow up and learn just how wicked this world is, they should pay serious attention to it and stop being manipulated by dirty old men. Everything has been brilliant up until Montreal, which is the worst town in the entire universe. There is a place that should be nuclear wasted.
Your partner doesn't agree. She thinks
the entire population of Montreal are scum.
Your
I say this quite casually.
People come because they want to see some kind of spectacle. They go and they wait
yeah.
for something to happen.
No, but only in Montreal has that happened. Everywhere else it's been, let's have a good time.
Yeah.
Right, they've understood that vibe.
Man.
See, we've been listening to our Led Zeppelin albums.
I think we have.
We're easily led, Zeppelin.
Yeah, the vibe wasn't happy.
So they were just laid back, is that right?
Yeah, there's no like relationship between the audience and the band.
It was too mellow.
We'd blown the mantra.
Now, when I first heard about you with the Sex Pistols, I always thought you were younger than me, younger and snottier. But now I cannot tell you how happy I am to hear that you're older than me. So tell me, now that you're entering your 30s...
You still look older.
Yeah, I still look older. I work harder.
Doesn't this teach you something?
Yeah.
You look lovely with a nice mohawk.
Yeah, but then I might be looking like I was trying to make some kind of meaningful statement, you know, like your hairdo. Is that kind of some kind of statement?
No, it's just hairpins and matted lumps of rubbish.
You put lacquer in it or something?
Hair is dead, you know, just play with it. That's all I do. No big deal.
So all this has a lot to do with, you know, aging with dignity.
He's got this thing about age, this man.
Yeah. What's your plans? Do you have any plans for the future?
To keep my waistline lower than my age, yes. Mm.
And your IQ higher than room temperature?
Yeah, yeah. Well, absolutely.
No, but seriously, like, do you have any books in the writing or anything like that? Did your parents ever teach you any manners, mate?
Yes.
But you've, I guess they just didn't fit in with your general scheme of
things. That's correct. Yeah. I knew better.
Yeah.
My way wins.
What music are you listening to these days? Do you like anything that's going on? Yeah, I'm asking you seriously for some positive...
I can't think of anything that's been released in the last 2 years that comes to mind instantly as striking me in any shape or form as being relevant to anything. It all just does seem to be pap now. Mm. Very M.O.R.
Mm. What's going to be on your next record?
M.O.R.
Well, with that hopeful note, thanks for burping with us. They put a hard wire to my head, 'cause of the things I didn't say, and made these feelings go away, for no citizen in every way.
Still ahead on the new music, Joe Jackson.